Hello friends, welcome to Fisheries Only, Nourishing Fish and Nurturing Life, an educational YouTube channel. Today we are going to share one more video regarding the physical, chemical and biological factors affecting fish culture. In this video we are going to clear the questions like what are the factors affecting fish culture, which care we have to taken while culturing. As we know, the successful fish farming or successful culture operation is mainly depends upon the maintenance of the environmental conditions, which is helpful for the production of the fish food organism as well as the health of the organism or health of the culture fish species. This environment mainly depends on the factors such as the physical factors, chemical factors and biological factors are responsible for the environment. In order to monitor the environmental condition, we have thoroughly understand the physical factors as well as biological and chemical factors, how they affects on the environment and hence the fish production as well as the production of the fish food organism and health condition of the fish. In this video we are going to discuss what are the physical factors affecting fish culture. In next video we are going to discuss the chemical as well as biological factors affecting on the fish culture. Hence fish culture mainly depends on environmental condition, and we have to thoroughly understand these factors so as we can monitor the physical factors, biological factors or chemical factors, so as we can keep the healthy environment, so as we consequently health of the culture fish organism. If the environment is healthy, our success culture chances, profitable chances is more. Now we are going to discuss what are the physical factors affecting the fish culture. In physical factors we are going to discuss the water depth, temperature, then turbidity, light and color of the water body, or what we can say the water in the pond. First one is water depth. Water depth is a key factor, is a vital factor, plays an important role in maintaining the water quality of the environment. It determines the temperature, light penetration, water circulation pattern as well as photosynthesis in the environment. Optimum water depth is required for fish as well as shellfish culture such as prawn culture is up to the 1 to 2 meter, which is required for the biological productivity. Biological productivity is nothing but the production of the phyto as well as zooplankton in the environment, and which is produced through the photosynthesis. If the water depth is more, light penetration affects, and then biological productivity gets affected. If the water depth is less, the light penetration up to the bottom, light penetrates up to the bottom, and bottom algal growth or bottom algal plants or bottom algal mats produce, which is harmful for the fish culture, which suddenly death affect the adversely on the fish culture. Hence water depth should be in optimum range. It is near about 1 to 2 meter for the fish culture and prawn culture. If water is it is also affected on the temperature. If the water depth is less, it light penetration is more and water temperature gets more. Diurnal variation of the temperature also depends on the water depth. It also changes more. Thus also circulation pattern also gets affected. When water get heated by the sunlights, and dense water comes lower side, then water depth also responsible for the biological productivity. Such when we light gets penetrate, the photosynthesis will affect, and photosynthesis will affect, it will reduce required for the production of the fish food organisms such as phytoplankton. Depending on the phytoplankton, zooplanktons also produce. Thus, the water depth is having a vital role on fish culture or successful fish farming. That's the water that we have to maintain in the fish culture system. The next one, the physical factor, is the temperature. It depends on the climatic conditions, sunlight, as well as the seasonal variations, as well as the depth of the water. That is, the temperature of the water body or environmental or pond water body is depend on the climatic conditions, season, as well as the depth of the culture water body. Temperature affects the migration of the fishes, as well as the reproduction of the fishes and distribution of the fishes, as well as the growth of the fishes. If the temperature, diurnal temperature, is more, then the fish gets affected, its appetite gets affected. Its optimum temperature range is about 20 to 32 degrees Celsius. For better growth of the animal, the water temperature should be the 20 to 32 degrees Celsius. Above that temperature, the fish biological activity gets affected and fish lose their appetite, fish consumes less food, and growth of the fish also gets affected. It uses more energy for maintenance of the body, and the energy which is used for the growth purpose is reduced, and the growth of the animal also reduced. In lower temperature also, what happens? The fish appetite gets reduced, fish appetite gets disturbed, and fish consume less food, and health of the or growth of the fish should be affected. The biological activity of the culture animal or fish culture is double after getting the 10 degree increase in the temperature. That's why the most of the energy is used for maintenance of the body rather than the for the growth purpose. Thus, the temperature mostly affect the growth of the fish culture. So, stocking of the fish seed in the culture, while releasing of the fish seed in the culture pond, we should acclimatize the for the temperature of the seed, so as we can reduce this mortality during the acclimatization period. We have to slowly adjust the seed bag temperature or fish seed bag temperature with the our culture water temperature. Thus, the temperature is a most important factors affecting fish culture, which is responsible for the fish appetite, increased appetite, and biological activity and growth and health of the animals. Optimum temperature ranges for freshwater fish culture as well as prawn culture is 20 to 32 degrees Celsius. Third one, physical factors affecting fish culture is turbidity. Turbidity is nothing but the opaqueness of the water body. How opaque our water body is measured in the form of turbidity. Turbidity may be occur due to the clay particles, sand particles, or phyto or zooplanktons present in the turbidity which occur due to the silt, clay, sand particles, sand granules, that called as a physical turbidity. And the turbidity which is created due to the sand particles, clay particles, or sand or silt particles, that turbidity is called as the physical turbidity, while the turbidity which is occur due to the created due to the phyto and zooplanktons that called as a plankton turbidity. Both physical as well as a plankton turbidity are responsible for the most important factors in the culture system. Turbidity is nothing but the opaqueness of the water body, which is measured by using a Secchi disc. Secchi disc is nothing but the circular plate having opposite black and white frame, and we have to insert in the water body, and when we this disc gets disappear, that point, that point or that depth we have to measure, and again we have to Secchi disc we have to remove, again it will be appear, that depth also we have to measure, and the average of the depth is turbidity, and it is majorly mostly in the centimeter. Turbidity reduces the sunlight penetration into the water body, hence sunlight penetration gets affected, then it will affect us on the photosynthesis of the at water body. When photosynthesis gets affected, the fish food production also gets affected, that the biological productivity of the pond also gets affected. Hence turbidity should be maintained. If water is more dense, the turbidity reading is less, and water become more dense, light penetration should be reduced, and photosynthesis gets stopped, dissolved oxygen production also gets stopped, and this condition is not preferable. In this situation, we have to increase the turbidity reading by taking measures, such as we can exchange water. Depending upon which type of turbidity is present, we can exchange the water, such as surface water or mid column water or bottom water, we can exchange. But also, if the turbidity is due to physical factors such as clay, silt and sand factors, the physical turbidity gets settles down on the fish body, also gets settled on the gills of the fishes, and fish gets disturbed while respiration, and this and biological other fish pathogen also affects or attached to the body and gets infected. That is the fish. The physical turbidity is more susceptible for disease causing in the culture animals. It is also, if it settles on the gills, it disturbs the respiration of the animals, and the health of the animals gets disturbed. For this purpose, mostly alum and lime we can use to reduce the physical turbidity. It can settle down on the bottom and turbidity reading will be increased. If the phytoplankton and zooplankton turbidity is more dense, we have to go for the water exchange. If the turbidity is less, then the turbidity reading will be more. In this time, we have to fertilize the pond water body in order to increase the photosynthesis and phyto and zooplankton production. Turbidity is mostly phyto and zooplankton turbidity is mostly preferable for the fish culture. We have to promote this turbidity. Thus, the monitoring of the turbidity mostly depends on the water exchange as well as using of lime and alum. The optimum range of the turbidity is 30 to 50 centimeters. 30 to 50 centimeter. If the water is turbidity reading is less than 30 centimeter, which is measured by the Secchi disc, and it is called as a dense water, and we have to go for the exchange of the water, or we have to use the alum and lime to settle down the physical turbidity. If the turbidity is more than the 50 centimeter, the water is less dense, turbidity is less dense, water is less productive, so we have to go for the production of the or fertilization of the pond water body, so as to increase the phyto and zooplankton production, which is responsible for the fish growth as well as fish health. Now we are going to discuss the fourth factor, color of water body. Color of the water body mainly arise due to the phyto and zooplankton present in the water body, as well as the sand particles, clay particles and sand granules present in this water body. Clear water or light green water, blue green water, golden water or yellow brown water color are present in the water body. Green color water body is mainly due to the phytoplanktons are more in the green color water body. Brown water may be present due to the presence of the zooplankton. Mostly diatoms are the present in the that water body. So color of the fish pond water is become brownish color. That is the green color is mainly due to the phytoplanktons are more, and brown water is zooplanktons are more. These two colors of the of water body is preferable. Sometimes clear water body also present, light green water body also present, blue or yellowish or brownish color water body also present. In clear water we have to use, that means the phytoplankton or zooplankton production is less, so we have to go for the fertilization of the pond so as to increase the productivity of plant and fish food production. Fish food production we have to improve in the culture water body so as to health or growth of the fish can get affected or maybe increased. Colors such as a black, dark color or dark green, red colors are not preferable. It may be due to the red colors may be appear due to the sudden death of the phyto and zooplankton, which is responsible for red formation of the red color of the body. In this toxic gases are more, and this dead material plankton and zooplankton gets decomposing. That's why the oxygen requirement, biological BOD oxygen requirement also gets more, and fish gets less oxygen, and in decomposing these plants their microbial growth also more, hence there is chances of fish gets affected by many fish parasitic diseases or bacterial diseases. Now we have to going to discuss fifth one. Physical factor is light. Light energy is essential for every life to grow and survive. It required some photo period. 8 to 9 hours photo period is sufficient for the fish culture organism. Light energy is required for photosynthesis of the photosynthesis in the environment so as to get so as to produce phytoplankton as well as zooplanktons. Zooplanktons and phytoplankton are the foods for the fish organism. Light penetration is mainly depends upon the turbidity of the water as well as the depth of the water. So if turbidity is in optimum range, depth in optimum range, light penetration is also in a optimum range so as to produce the photosynthesis. In this photosynthesis, dissolved oxygen is produced, which is helpful for the healthy maintenance of the fish cultures. Light availability, light energy or light availability depends upon the climatic conditions. Cloudy conditions also gets affected on these conditions. Also the season also affect the light's availability. Thus the light energy is mainly responsible for the biological productivity of the pond water body. Hello friends, in this video we have discussed what are the physical factors affecting fish culture, how to maintain these factors so as to our environment gets healthy and fish production will be more, or success of the fish production will be sustainable, or definitely we can achieve the success. If you like this video, please subscribe the channel and promote the channel. In next video, we have to going to share the another two aspects, such as the chemical factors and biological factors affecting the fish culture. Thank you.